The Alaska Department of Transportation and Public Facilities proposed a land-based airport to improve access to Angoon, a remote and isolated village on Admiralty Island in southeast Alaska. SWCA Environmental Consultants was contracted to prepare an environmental impact statement. This required extensive surveys of the surrounding freshwater, estuarine, and marine areas. While aquatic fieldwork is typically done by scuba divers, the project's remote location and scattered study sites made transportation of diving equipment tricky, and its vast size meant a time crunch for divers whose work can often be slow and difficult. So instead, SWCA used a high-resolution, battery-operated underwater camera lowered from a boat. Here is some of the underwater footage they recorded. One of the study sites was Peahen Passage, known as Women's Passage on maps. It's an area rich in marine life thanks to its unique geology and its protected location between the strong currents of Kootsnahoo Inlet and the calm waters of Favorite Bay. From the boat, scientists viewed 360-degree video on a color LCD monitor and recorded the footage to DVD. The data were linked to GPS to pinpoint the exact location of aquatic species and habitats. As the tide comes in, salmon and trout move up into Favorite Creek, with sockeye, pink, and chum salmon being the first to return to freshwater on their annual spawning migration. Cutthroat trout feed on the eggs, and Angoon residents, too, take advantage of the bounty. Among the many species SWCA scientists encountered during their underwater exploration was this quillback rockfish, trawling near the dock in Killis New Harbor. Named for venomous dorsal fin rays that deter would-be predators and inflict pain on unsuspecting fishermen, the quillback rockfish is common in saltwater areas around Angoon during the summer. The area is home to at least 8 species of flatfish, including halibut, flounder, and this sole in Killis New Harbor. Just after sunset near the Angoon floatplane dock, juvenile walleye pollock swarm to the light of the camera, illuminating prey in the water column. Estuaries such as Favorite Bay provide nursery grounds for many fish, whose offspring develop in waters rich in food, yet sheltered from lurking offshore predators. These pollock are just one of many species that the airport project could impact. At the entrance to Kootsnahoo Inlet near Danger Point are schooling herring, a fish that has featured prominently in Tlingit culture for thousands of years. Herring attracts several other species that locals have relied upon for survival, drawing humpback and killer whales, seals and sea lions, salmon, halibut, and bald eagles. The camera's LED lights attract an attacking halibut. When researchers played back the video in slow motion, they could see down the throat of this aggressive fish. Luckily, it was only in the 30 to 40 pound range. Had it been one of the 300 pounders commonly found near Angoon, there may have been nothing left of the camera.